Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new around here, welcome. My name is Elise and I would love for you to hit that subscribe button and join my little YouTube family. So for today's video, I'm going to be doing my November favorites because I can't believe we're already entering December. That is crazy to me and it is just, it's always crazy to me, okay? I always say that, people. It's just always crazy that we're entering the months so quickly and the days feel so long. Okay. So yeah, I'm gonna jump right in and I hope you guys enjoy. So the first product that I wanted to give a shout out to this month is this L'Oreal Lash Paradise Voluminous Mascara. You guys, this mascara is literally dreamy. It is the best mascara from the drugstore. I love this mascara. I actually shouldn't say it's the best, but it's definitely like top three for me. It's definitely like climbed its little way up, all the way up to top three. That's a big deal, okay? I do have really short, sparse lashes. They're not long, they're not luscious, they're not beautiful. So when I tell you guys that I like a mascara, that usually means a lot to me because it takes a lot of effort, a lot of time for me to actually get my lashes to look presentable, for me at least. I do not like to layer my mascara, so for that reason I like to find one that will do it all for me. And you guys, this mascara is so good. It does a great job with volume, it does a great job with lengthening, which is huge for me, and it doesn't clump my lashes. It's just a beautiful mascara. You guys, I don't know why I've waited so long to try this mascara. If you are looking for a good drugstore affordable mascara that is going to do it up for your lashes, quick side note, I did film this makeup tutorial. It is already on my channel. I will link it down below if you haven't seen it, but it should be the video previous to this one. So check that out if you're interested. I will leave it listed down below for those of you who want to see how I did my makeup. So the next product that I've been loving this month is this Pure Mineral Glow Bronzer. I have used it in several tutorials. If you look back a couple tutorials, this has been the bronzer that I've used in all of them. For the most part, this is just a really beautiful bronzer. It gives me a nice sun-kissed glow and it's not over the top. It's not too muddy and it's also not too orange. But this bronzer is actually beautiful and it just complements my skin tone so well. I honestly love it. It's not matte. It has some subtle shimmer in it, but it's very, very complimentary and it's not over the top. It's not chunky like glitter by any means. It's very, very beautiful. I have it on today and usually I've been putting this on and I'm not even contouring. Like, I am just going to town with my damn bronzer. So I highly recommend it if you guys haven't checked it out, and good job to Pure because this is some good stuff. Next up, I wanted to talk about this Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Aqua Sealer. This is a concealer by Tarte from the Rainforest of the Sea line that they have. This was actually on sale a couple of weeks ago on Sephora, and that's when I snagged it up. Yes, honey, I was trying to save them coins, so I bought it. Sometimes that like offers section in Sephora is a little sketchy because you're like, why is that on sale? Why you on sale, honey? Like, what's really good? So I'm happy I got this. It's actually a really good concealer. I used it today. I've used it several times this month and I keep going back to it, so that means I like it. It's a really lightweight concealer and that is what I like most about it. I have been using Tarte Shape Tape a whole lot, and that is a very thick, very full coverage concealer. It's a great, wonderful concealer if you're looking for that full coverage look. But I've been loving this concealer because I actually feel like it's the opposite. It's lightweight, it's not full coverage, it's more like a medium coverage, and it blends out really sheerly but in a very flattering way because it's not like you're being left without any coverage. It gives you coverage but it's not like over the top, it's not too like heavy, and that is definitely what I've been going for lately. The only drawback that it does have is it has a really strong paint smell, but once you blend it out, to me, I don't even smell it. It's not something that stays or lingers by any means. I actually really don't smell it anymore once I actually blend it out. So that's kind of a drawback. If you're very sensitive to smells, you might not like this, but if you can look past it and you can kind of go about it and just blend it and kind of just forget about it, I think you'll be okay. This is actually a hair product, but I wanted to give it a quick shout out because it definitely so deserves it. This is actually a Denman brush. This is the 9-row large styling brush. You guys, this brush is amazing. I kept the box for you guys, but honestly it keeps coming out of the box because it's not even having it. I have been trying to go back to my natural state. I do have naturally really curly hair and I do have my hair dry right now, but I've been trying to cut back on heat substantially. I only dry my hair once every 2 months and I have it dry now for the holidays. After that, I'm definitely going back to having it in my little bun with my leave-in conditioner because, you know, I am playing no kinds of games. I want them curls to come back strong. That's not even the point. The point of this is this brush is amazing and it's awesome if you are trying to go natural. It is amazing for detangling. It doesn't tug your hair and doesn't rip it to shreds. And you do experience some shredding, but that's obviously normal. You're gonna experience that all the time. But this, I do feel like, does a great job at taming the amount of shedding that you're going to get. Other brushes that I was using, it was really ripping my hair out and really breaking it. And I could literally see it broken because I would feel like pieces of my hair not as long as other pieces. Like, my hair was breaking. And I think it was honestly something I was doing in the actual detangling process. I think I was using the wrong things. So ever since I've started using this brush, which I actually purchased very early November, I think I might have even purchased this late October from Amazon. This brush is super inexpensive. It costs like less than 12 bucks. I will link it down below so you guys can definitely check it out if you haven't. But this brush is amazing. You don't have to have curly hair to love this brush. I honestly think it would work for any single type of hair, whether your hair is thin and straight, whether your hair is wavy, whether your hair is thick and curly. I think you would love this brush for detangling and for really helping tame your hair if it's frizzy. So it just does a really great job, and I just wanted to give it a shout out. So I've been really trying to get on top of my skincare because my regimen is not all that. It is not popping. It is not the best. I really get really bad pimples. I feel like a huge contributing factor is that my skincare isn't tippity top, like 110%. Like, it's not strong. My skincare game is not strong, okay? I think I need to get better with that. So I've been trying lately to really make sure that I'm really testing things out, really paying attention to what's working for my skin, and really just seeing if it works or if it doesn't work. So the whole point of my little spiel there was I really want to pay attention to my skin. I really want to make sure that I'm doing what I need for it, and I'm giving it what it needs to be healthy, to be strong, and to look its best. With that being said, I have tried these Clinique moisturizers and I really like them, so I wanted to give them a shout out because I do think they have contributed to my skin being a lot better than it used to be. This is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. This is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Lotion. The moisturizing gel is a moisturizer, but it is a gel-like formula where it's not a lotion, it's not thick, and it's very light. So I usually apply this every morning, which I didn't do before. I didn't really wear moisturizer like every morning, which I've noticed a very substantial difference in the way my skin not only looks, the way it feels throughout the day. I've noticed a big difference with this because it has a more lightweight formula and it's not as heavy as a thick lotion. It's comfortable and it does its job at keeping my skin hydrated throughout the day, but not overly hydrated. But then this, which is the lotion, and don't be confused, they look the same but they're different because this is the lotion. So with the lotion, I'll wear this at night, and what I do is I pour in a couple drops of rosehip oil every night before I go to bed, put a couple drops of this, rub it, and put it on my face. It's thicker than the gel, and it's not as lightweight, which is why I wear it at night, because it lets my skin just really drink it up. So yeah, overall I have really been loving this combination. They are not sold as a duo either. They're sold as two totally different things. I don't know if I'm confusing you guys by showing it like this. So you might want to try these out if you haven't already. I really do like them and they're really giving me some pretty good results. So guys, that's pretty much going to complete my beauty favorites section. I'm going to go ahead and jump into my song favorites. I usually do this every month. I've been doing it for the past couple months. So if you're interested in seeing what I've been jamming to, please keep watching. 'Cause you're perfect and I know that you're worth it. I can't walk away. Even though I'm going through it and that makes you feel alone, just know that I would die for you. Baby, I would die for you. Yeah. Tú me robaste el corazón como un criminal. Baby, yo no puedo negar esto que siento por ti. It's holiday season, so y'all know that Christmas playlist is on deck, right? Sleigh bells ring, I am listening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in the winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. Last Christmas I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Candles burning low, lots of mistletoe, lots of snow and ice everywhere we go. All these things and more, needs to be my love. Say now, if you get this letter, won't you help me out? I know you're kinda busy with your elves right now, and I don't know how. Who did you do when I sleep on Christmas Eve? But it's amazing, and I bet that you could rip it back, my baby. Yes, queen, yes.
And I wanna come and make it mine this Christmas night. Ho, ho, ho. Santa's gonna come and make it mine this Christmas. I just want you for my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. All I want for Christmas is you. You, baby.
So you guys, it's pretty much going to complete this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful and enjoyed spending a little bit of time here with me today. Please don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it, and please don't forget to subscribe if you are not already subscribed. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.